Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Roddy and I'm a filmmaker. Today, I really want to talk to you about the script and the idea of a film called Hearst Buddies that's uploaded to this channel. So before you watch this, go and watch the film. I'm going to put the link into the description below, so no spoilers. A while back, a friend of mine bought a Hearst for really cheap, and I thought that this is too good of an opportunity not to do something really fun with it. So I went away and I wrote something called Hearst Buddies. I knew we have a hearse to work with, and I was wondering what kind of funny stories there are around a hearse to be told. So I knew I need to have at least a couple of guys, and not only that, but they need to be buddies at some point in time. The first script I wrote had the two guys be long old friends that are slightly dumb and do bad things for personal gain, but wouldn't really hurt anybody. Much like Horace and Jasper.
Hey, Horace, me lad, I've got a sneaky suspicion we're not welcome here.
I wrote them separated, but both individually missing the life of heists, and together coming for one last failed hit. After I wrote this first draft, I gave it to Ruby to read and dissect and critique, and she found a very big problem. The hearse was just a vehicle into the story. If we were to replace it with any other car, a bike, or even a clown buggy, the story wouldn't change much. Which was a problem because we wanted to have the hearse to be instrumental for the completion of the story. So I had to go back and rewrite all that. Now I wrote them as cemetery workers, and not very good ones either. David, the one with the driving license, driving the hearse, having authority over Leroy, the one that had the sense of adventure and slightly dumb ideas. Now it was better. They had a job, the job had a hearse, and both of them wanted to find a better way for themselves, so they decided to rob a large metal organization. And the only thing to do it with was a hearse. Now it was a heist film and it had a hearse in it. And that's the funny. Meanwhile, Ruby was working on some original art. She created the designs and the logos of the Flying Milkshake, the fictional milkshake place that we wrote into the script, which acted as a front for the meth organization, as well as a couple of concept arts that we're going to be sending along with the script to everybody that we're going to be asking to help us to make this film possible. There are a couple of ideas and designs that didn't work out, but there are a few that did. And I thought that if we take the design of the logo of the milkshake and replace the wings with guns, we'll have it. We'll have the Hearst Buddies concept. It was colorful, wacky, and strange enough to make you say, what? And with all that said and done, written and rewritten a couple of times, we ended up with the script and the idea of Hearst Buddies. The very first draft I wrote and the draft that we ended up shooting, I'm gonna put the link in the description for those so we can go and download them for yourselves. But yeah, basically, Hearst Buddies. Go and watch it. It's on YouTube now. Thanks. Is that it? Do I need a little dance? We need to sing myself out. No? Okay. See you later.